Hi guys, welcome to Code Bashers. Guys, in this video, I will be discussing the Infosys interview experience of a selected candidate. This interview happened recently only and this guy got the offer letter in 7 days. So guys, make sure that you do not miss any part of this video and watch the video till the end. Guys, this is I think the 7th or 8th Infosys SC interview experience that I am covering on my channel. 7 or 8 videos have already been uploaded, and for all the roles in Infosys you can find the interview experiences in this playlist. I will give the link of this playlist in the I button or in the description box. Make sure to visit it. And guys, also I have recently started my blog channel also. In this blog also I post the questions which are getting asked in the companies as well as their interview experiences. Infosys 5 interview SC experiences have been posted. You can see here experience 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 5 interview experiences of Infosys SC hiring has been posted. So make sure to visit my blog also. The link is in the description box. Do not miss any update from my channel, whether it is from blog or whether it is from the YouTube channel. So guys, now let's start this video, and before starting the video, please hit the like button. Okay, so guys, the date of the interview was 10th December 2021. The branch of my friend was CSC. The duration of the entire interview was just 10 minutes, and the date on which he got the selection mail, or you can say the offer letter, was 17th December. So in just 7 days, he received the offer letter from Infosys. Okay, so the first question, as you all know, will be self-introduction. That is, you will have to introduce yourself. So guys, this is the very important question of your interview. It can decide that where your interview will lead. So kindly mention only those things in which you are comfortable in, and you can simply answer in the interview. You can include your projects, your internships or extracurricular activities and many more things which you have done in your college time. So kindly prepare this question very well for your interviews. Okay. Next question was again a very simple question, that what is the working of a for loop. So first of all, for working of a for loop, you must know the syntax. So syntax of the for loop is this, that is for int a is equal to 10, a less than 20, a plus 1. So how this goes? So first of all, this value is taken, then this condition is checked. If this condition is true, then the control of the loop will go inside this loop and execute the statements which are present in the loop. And once the body of the loop is over, then it will be incremented. A is equal to a plus 1. So initially it was 10, starting from 10. Now a has become 11, and again this condition will be checked, and again the loop will run. So it will run till this condition is not fulfilled. Condition is fulfilled. So I hope this question is clear to you. It was a very basic question that can be asked from you. Okay, the next question was, what is the difference between GetH and GetCHE? So again, this is not that common question, but yes, this question was asked from this candidate. So I will give the link of this particular question in the description box. Make sure to visit that link and know the answer for your questions. Okay, so the next question was difference between call by value and call by reference. So guys, for both of these, call by value means while calling a function, we pass values of variables to it. Such functions are known as call by values. So whenever we are calling a function, we are passing the values of variables in it. But in call by reference, while calling a function, instead of passing the values of variable, we pass address of variables. So this is a very the main difference between these two things, that in call by value we pass the value parameters value, but in call by reference we pass the parameters address. So if any changes happens to the variable in call by value, that changes are not reflected in the main function. But if any changes in call by reference happens to that variable, then those changes are also reflected in the main function. So this was the main difference between call by value and call by reference. I hope this definition is clear to you. Okay, so the next question was, what is the difference between doubly linked list and singly linked list? So the difference between single and doubly linked list is that a singly linked list has nodes with data field and a next link field. That means in single linked list, we can only move towards the right. Starting from left, we can only move towards the right. So in singly linked list, the node consists of only two values, that is the data node and the address of the next node. In doubly linked list, we can traverse either on the left side also and on the right side also. So a doubly linked list contains three things in a node, that is the address to the previous node, the data, and then the address of the next node. I hope this difference is clear to you. These three points are defining same thing only. Major difference I have told you, and in single linked list we can only move in one direction, but in doubly linked list we can move in both the directions from the nodes. I hope this question is clear to you. Okay, so the last thing that the candidate wanted to say, that only basic things that we have mentioned in resume were asked. So guys, prepare your introduce yourself very well and prepare your resume very well. That is the project that you have added in your resume. That will be the key factor in an interview, because mostly the interviews of this kind happens from your resume only. That what are your projects, what difficulties you face in projects, what are your skills, where you have done certifications, what are the different types of certifications you have done. So all these things are a part of resume based only. So kindly, if your first preference, if you have interviews in 1 or 2 days, your first preference should be to read your resume and find out that what all things you have written in that and how you will have to explain to the interviewer. And then if the time remains, then you can focus on various aspects, like what will be the question asked from DBMS or certain other subjects. So you can do it, but first preference you should give to your resume. So I hope this video was helpful for you while you are preparing for your interviews. And guys, kindly do not forget to check out my both YouTube playlist also, as well as my blog also for interview experiences. I will give the link of these two things in the description box. Thank you for watching this video.